Parvez Ashraf is declared to have been elected as the Prime Minister of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan.
And with that, Raja Parvez Ashraf became Pakistan's 25th Prime Minister. Many had hoped Yusuf Reza Gilani's replacement would restore calm after months of political and judicial turmoil. But the decision to pick Ashraf almost guarantees the crisis will continue. The former water and power minister is a longtime loyalist of President Asif Ali Zardari and won't likely challenge him. But he is also widely seen as corrupt for his alleged role in a scam involving the rental of power projects. He's also closely associated with the current energy crisis that has crippled the country.
Raja Parvez Ashraf is a controversial person by all standards. Not only is he controversial in terms of the allegations on him, he's actually under investigation by the Supreme Court for acts of omission and commission when he was the Minister for Water and Power. So that's one. The other, of course, is the fact that he was a hugely incompetent minister. So, you know, he has a deadly combination of being under investigation for ethical practices and for not being able to deliver on his promises.
Naveed Gummer is the outgoing petroleum minister for the ruling Pakistan People's Party. He says the corruption allegations against the new PM are baseless.
Charges fly very freely in a country like Pakistan when it comes to anything that can be thrown at you. Charges that need to be proved in any court of law. Raja, being a seasoned politician, will go ahead and at least take initial steps, which will start healing some of the wounds, and there are a lot of wounds out there.
Wounds many Pakistanis don't see Ashraf healing.
I have little hope from the new prime minister. He will fill his pockets and steal from the people. Everyone in the government is corrupt.
He was the minister for power and water. He didn't solve anything. The situation is much worse now. The prime minister needs to think of the poor and solve our problems.
Ashraf has been described as a placeholder prime minister who won't likely accomplish much during his time in office. Parliamentary elections are scheduled for next March, but could be held as early as this year. Many believe the Supreme Court will order Ashraf to write to the Swiss authorities to reopen a corruption case against President Asif Ali Zardari, and that if he refuses, he too will be disqualified like his predecessor. And while it's too early to say just what exactly will happen next, the reality is that Pakistan's many pressing problems will likely remain unsolved, even with the new prime minister at the helm. Imtiaz Taib, Al Jazeera, Islamabad.